This episode of Ask Jay is brought to you by Netflix. Taking your business to the next level with marketing, coming up. I'm Jay Adelson, and I'm the founder and chairman of Revision 3. I've started and built a number of companies. My goal in this show is to pass on some of the knowledge from my experiences to you, the budding entrepreneurs, and hopefully leave you with some words of wisdom. Today's question comes from Adrian in Hong Kong, who writes, "Hello, Jay. My question's regarding marketing. I've already got a company and a product. It's a boutique fitness company where I offer different types of training to the general public. Could you shed some light on both branding, logos, brand consistency, slogans, website fonts, colors, etc., and marketing, how to market my company and products? Should I do magazine ads, Google search words, etc.?" Adrian, you're asking about marketing, and you know, I myself, I'm not a marketing wizard. It is not my area of expertise. I've brought people in the past into my businesses to help me with that. But I will say that as a general rule, you know, I think about my market. You're talking about a fitness company, and you want to obviously access them where they are. Traditional forms of marketing, things like wrapping buses, billboards, you know, magazine ads, are extremely expensive. So unless you have a lot of venture funding and you're already moving in that direction, you know, investing in those kinds of things, it's going to take a big portion of your budget. Now, I think there are those who would argue that in a business like yours, a boutique fitness company or personal training or whatever it might be, you know, it's probably going to be a large percentage of your budget. So it's not too crazy to spend a lot of your budget on, in fact, the marketing of it. This isn't my best area. I'm not a marketing wizard. And so I think that this is a case where, again, we should give this question to Nigel, who's the chief marketing officer at AMD, who definitely has a lot more experience in this sort of area. But first, I want to thank our sponsor. Today's episode is brought to you by Netflix. Netflix streams TV shows and movies directly to your home, saving you time, money, and hassle. As a Netflix Unlimited member, you can instantly watch TV episodes and movies streaming directly to your PC, Mac, or right to your TV with your Xbox 360, PS3, or Nintendo Wii. Watch as many movies as you want, anytime you want, and cancel anytime. For a limited time, you can get a free 30-day trial membership. Go to www.netflix.com/AskJay and sign up now. Be sure to use this URL so they know we sent you.
Adrian, I recently joined a gym myself, trying to lose a bit of weight, get a bit fitter, and I went somewhere where I could find professionals. I sort of guess that's what you're looking for as well. You know, marketing can be very much the same way. Lots of people out there who can help you get your marketing fit and better. When you're waiting to work with them, here are 10 things to think about. Okay, number one, know your value proposition. You need to be clear on your value proposition. That's the thing that makes you different. We talk more about value propositions in episode 34 of the Ask Jay series called Generating Buzz. Number two, keep it simple. Okay, so you probably have an idea for a logo, and if you don't, you can crowdsource one from any number of sites out there. You've got a name, and you've probably got a series of colors. Write them down and make sure they're simple and they look good. You know, if you create things that are very complicated, they're very difficult to recreate, particularly when you want to put them on t-shirts or hats or other types of merchandise. Number three, be consistent. You need to be consistent in what you do. One of the great examples is something like fonts. Your logo probably has a font, you've probably got a font you like. Make sure that font exists on your PC. If it doesn't, you're gonna have to go and buy it. And you're gonna wanna make sure everything you do has the same font. Be consistent, make sure you're using a standard set of fonts. Number four, own what you use. You're probably gonna wanna use images and pictures. Make sure you own them. Even if you go to a royalty-free site and check the terms and conditions, make sure they're going to allow you to be commercially using those pictures. Best thing to do, of course, is take your own pictures. But if you do, make sure you have permission to use the images of the people. Number five, plan your website out clearly. Okay, go to a few competitors, go to a few websites you like. What do you like about them? And then remember, keep the URL, which is the web address, really easy. And make sure whoever designs your site, it's really easy to add content to. Number six, one look and feel. Okay, you got a logo, you got a website, maybe have brochures or guides or leaflets. Make sure they look like they come from the same company. Nothing more distracting when you use too many different looks and feels. Okay, when it comes to building a marketing plan, number seven, be an expert on your customers. So before you spend $1 on marketing, ask the six questions about your your customers. Who are they? What are they like? How do they like it? Where do they like it? When do they like it? And why do they like it? You've really got to know the answers to those questions. Number eight, everything you do, test. Okay, test your deliverables, your questions, your answers, your thoughts with prospective customers. Okay, maybe that's friends or families, but don't let them just tell you how great it looks. You need honest feedback about what's going to work and what's not. Number nine, don't do it all at once. New businesses have a tendency to throw everything against the wall to see what sticks. If you do, you'll never know which tactic was working and which wasn't. So do one tactic at a time. And number 10, track everything you do. Okay, whatever you do in terms of marketing, track it and measure it to make sure it's being successful. You do that with promotional codes or offering codes. You can use a service like Groupon that's really good because when you do a promotion, you can actually see who buys it. Be careful of marketing tactics like buying AdWords, where you can see how many people are looking at your website, but it's very hard to know whether they actually came and shopped with you. I hope those 10 things help, and good luck with your business.
Thanks, Nigel. Great stuff. Please keep your questions coming to AskJayAdelson@revision3.com. Also, love to see you on Twitter at Jay Adelson and Facebook at the Ask Jay Adelson channel. And love to see those video response questions on YouTube on the Ask Jay Adelson channel. So until next time, thanks for joining us.